You called me from the grave by name. You called me out of all.
Well, I'd say good evening to everyone. We just getting started on the CMW. The CWM radio show. I'm sorry. CWM radio show. Tonight, your host is Apostle Michael Branch, and we're going to be hearing from the man of God in just a little bit. We did start a little bit. We had technical issues on this tonight. Now, I do apologize. We normally start at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so enjoy, and we'll be ready for a word in just a bit. Again, you're listening to CWM radio show each and every week, Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. God bless you, and we'll be right back.
For joining us this morning, amen, for the Saturday morning prayer experience. We had a couple of minutes of worship. We'd like to set the tone for the Word of God. We're going to be brief this morning, but we certainly want to bring you the Word of God before we pray, amen. Once again, those of you that follow us each and every Saturday morning, we are just grateful. Those that may be watching or listening for the very first time, we're just so grateful that you joined us. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Certainly he is the head of our life, and we want to make sure that we lift him up. He said if he be lifted, then men would be drawn unto him. So our purpose this morning is to bring glory to the Lord, amen, to the Word of God, to get us in his will and in his way, amen. For those of you that have your Bible, we're coming from 1 Chronicles, the 4th chapter. We're going to deal with a few things this morning. I just want to read one scripture to get us started. Amen. And to sort of set the tone for what we're going to talk about for a couple of minutes. But let's pray. Father, we thank you this morning. We bless you. We give you honor and give you glory. We thank you for life, health, and strength. We thank you, God, that you're so merciful to us. You look way beyond our faults and you still supplied our needs. Even while we were in the midst of our mess, you still showed us mercy, and your grace has been sufficient. Now, God, hide me and mute me that you might be seen and heard. And I pray that the heart of the hearer be pierced, God, even to the marrow of the heart. And let this word be life-changing, not only for them, but even for me, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Lord, we thank you. Amen and amen. Once again, we're coming from the book of 1 Chronicles, the 4th chapter. And I think I want to read verse 9. And it says, and Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. And his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow. I'm going to stop right there, but I want to read that word just one more time. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. And his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow. In other words, when she was pregnant, when she was in labor, she was in much pain during the delivery. How many of us, and I'm asking that question, and you can take that question for yourself, woke up this morning and your situation wasn't ideal? And I can imagine many people are waking up this morning. Some is waking up to the joy of the day because everything in their life may seem to be intact. Their bills may be paid, and they know exactly where their children are. There's no frustration between the husband and the wife. Their home is intact. Job security, education is well taken care of. But on the flip side of that, there are some that woke up this morning and their situation wasn't so ideal. Somebody probably woke up this morning and said, I wish I was still asleep, because the moment I woke up, my problems begin to attack me. My mind, I wish I could go to a wall socket and just click my mind off. I wish I didn't have to think about what I have to go through. Some of us are waking up thinking about even next week, because we know that we're facing some uphill battles next week. Our backs are against the wall. We got some deadlines we got to deal with. We don't see how in the world that we're going to achieve these things. And as I begin, even in the course of the night, I hadn't been to sleep all night. I was off of work last night, but hadn't been to sleep all night. And I was looking at this word, and I said, oh, Lord, I said, it blessed me, because when I read that scripture, and I'm going to read it just one more time, because I want everybody to catch this. He says, and Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. See, the key to it is being honorable. See, even though you may have woke up not to the best situation, if your lifestyle is conducive to God, if it's conducive to Him moving in your life, regardless of what your situation is, you still gonna make it. You know why? Because He said you are more than a conqueror. He said the battle is already won. See, we begin to fight battles that we shouldn't even be fighting. He said the battle belongs to Him. But we in our natural, my God, right here, we in our natural state begin to forget that the battle don't belong to us. And we, even though we pray, my God, right here, see, we forget even in our prayers that when we pray, even then, we must be conducive, hallelujah, to the blessings of the Lord in order for God to move in our situation. Not to say that He won't still move, but if you're like me, I'll be wanting a right now move. I'll be wanting all of a sudden move, an instant move of God. When I pray, I want things to happen. The moment I begin to pray, the moment that the words begin to come out of my mouth, I want God to move. But we must be conducive. Our lifestyle must be right, hallelujah, with God, to make God move. And the Bible clearly says here that Jabez was honorable. My God, right there. He was honorable. And it says, even more than his brethren. And his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bore him in sorrow. Watch this. The Bible don't do too much talking about Jabez by mentioning his name. But scripture talks about him indirectly. Matter of fact, Proverbs and Psalms talks about Jabez, but they just don't mention his name, but the reference is there. So if you do your research, it even talks about him in the New Testament, in the book of Romans. They talk about Jabez. But because they're talking about him, they're talking about just how honorable Jabez was. Jabez, hallelujah, Jesus. Jabez, he was known for prayer. My God. He was known for prayer, and he was known for the simplicity of his prayer. In other words, when Jabez prayed, he didn't try to get all fancy. When Jabez prayed, he didn't try to use a whole bunch of big words. When Jabez prayed, he didn't waste God time. Because he was honorable, he knew what he needed from God, and he asked God. He made it plain, and he made it simple. He didn't try to be somebody that he wasn't just because he was in prayer. Whether he was praying in front of an audience or he was in his secret closet, he was known for the simplicity of prayer. I went on and I began to look up a little bit more of the history of Jabez. And another thing they talked about Jabez was his goodness. Jabez was good. He was a righteous man. The Bible said that that Jabez, hallelujah, made sure for one thing that his debts were paid. He made sure, hallelujah, that his integrity was intact. He made sure that he treated his neighbors right. He made sure that he honored his mother. Hallelujah, Jesus. He made sure, hallelujah, that he fed the poor. He made sure that everything around him was done in decency and order. Why? Because it was honorable not just to him, but it was honorable to God. His name was Jabez. Hallelujah, Jesus. And let me just take him in. His mother said, now I bore him in pain. In other words, when she had, hallelujah, Jabez, glory be to God, she was in pain. And even in Jabez's childhood, the only thing he saw was the pain of a mother. Even though she had already birthed him, his childhood was still dealing with the pain of his mother because she never really got over the pain. Hallelujah. But Jabez attended to her like a servant would a man or woman of God. He attended to his mother, and it was what? Honorable to God. So let me just tell you a few more things about Jabez here. Jabez, watch this right here. Jabez, now watch this. He said a lack of integrity couldn't make the man to be the man. He said the lack, hallelujah, of honoring those, hallelujah, in leadership wouldn't make him the man. Hallelujah. What made him the man was his mother. Good God. See, the Bible don't talk about Jabez's father. It talks about his mother. His mother, hallelujah, made him into the man that he was supposed to be. Why? Because she was a righteous woman. So everything that God had instilled in her, she instilled in Jabez, and Jabez didn't stray far, hallelujah, from his mother. So Jabez goes on now, and he's righteous. I told y'all I ain't going to be before you very long. I'm going to cut this thing off right here. But let me just read something else to you real quick. Glory to God. Jabez, now, I just want to drop down just one more verse and read verse 10. Watch this. The Bible says, and Jabez called on God, the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed. See, Jabez now, with the relationship that he got with God, knowing that his life is conducive to whatever he went to God for, God would answer him. So he says, that thou wouldest bless me indeed and enlarge my coast. In other words, Jabez had gotten to the point where he said, my territory ain't big enough, and I want you to enlarge my camp. I need you to scatter me out a little bit further. I feel like I'm getting claustrophobia in the little place that you got me in. But the thing of it was, hallelujah, we're going to see it in just a minute. What Jabez asked God, he went in confidence, knowing that it was going to happen. Let's read. He said this right here. Bless me indeed and enlarge my coast, and that thine hand might be with me. In other words, he said, everything that I do, everywhere I go, as long as I'm in your favor, as long as I have made my life conducive to that which I'm asking you for, I need your hand to stay upon me. When my enemies come against me, when they come in like a flood, I ain't got nothing to worry about. When my bills are due, I still ain't got nothing to worry about. Even when I don't have no money in my pocket, I know that you're still going to make a way. My back may be against the wall, but I'm still, hallelujah, going to press forward. Why? Because I know that you have my back. Then he goes on, he says this right here. He says, and that thou wouldest keep me from evil. In other words, he said, don't even let my mind fool me. Don't even let my own heart deceive me. Keep me out of harm's way. Hallelujah, don't let me do nothing to even harm myself, more or less, and let the enemy come and create havoc in my life. And then he goes on to say this right here. He says, now keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And watch this right here. Now here's the kicker. And God granted him that which he requested. I told y'all we're going to be before you very long. I love the last part of that. And God granted him what he requested. Let me tell y'all something. For those of you that woke up this morning feeling sorrowful, for those of you that woke up this morning, you ain't got a penny to your name. For those of you that woke up this morning, hallelujah, don't know where your children are because they didn't come in last night. Those of you that woke up this morning, you already fighting with your husband or your wife. Those of you that got started this morning with an eviction notice on your door, let me tell you something. Get your life right. Get your life right, because if your life line up with the word of God, if you are honorable, if you got integrity, he said, ask what thy will of me, and I'll give it to you. Oh, let me give you one more instance right here. Remember now, my God, help me, Holy Ghost, when Paul and Silas was over in the prison. Amen. The only thing they had been doing was preaching and teaching the word of God. But they got thrown in the prison. But right around midnight, they began to pray. They began to sing songs. Even though what they had done did not, hallelujah, make it so that they would be in there. They just got thrown in the prison. But God had ordained something for them so somebody could get saved. Your situation may be ordained that your back is against the wall. Why? Just so somebody could get saved. I'm here to tell you this morning, but then God moved. They said instantly, all of a sudden, an earthquake. How many of you need an earthquake in your life this morning? How many of you need God to move with power? Move right now. I don't know about you, but I need God. I need him to move in my life. Amen. And I'm going to give him the glory in advance. Come on. If you're like me this morning, I'm going to pray a Jabez prayer. My God, right here. I'm going to pray a prayer with confidence. I'm going to pray a prayer that said, God, I need you right now. I need you to expand me. Enlarge my coast. Enlarge my territory. Bring me into a wealthy place. Begin now to educate my mind with your spirit. Begin to regurgitate every bit of your word in me that I might be conducive to everything that you want me to do. I want to meet my mandate. Glory be to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. That's it. I ain't even going to say no more. I'm going to stop because the Holy Spirit says stop. But let me tell you something. Hallelujah. Get yourself in posture for prayer this morning. Get yourself in prayer mode because we're going to go to the Lord in prayer. Amen. My wife, Apostle Annette, she's going to come and pray for us. Hallelujah, Jesus. I feel the Spirit of the living God in here this morning. Jabez's prayers was granted because God found him to be an honorable man, an integrous man, a man that nobody could even begin to think of something wrong with. So even if someone came to witness falsely against him, my God, man may have been tricked, but God won't. This is why when Jabez prayed, my God, right here, when he prayed, he knew God was going to do exceedingly and abundantly more than he could ever fasten in his mind. Glory be to God. If you want to know a few more scriptures that mention about Jabez, amen, just go to Leviticus, the 19th chapter, Deuteronomy, the 25th chapter. Amen. Proverbs, the 11th chapter, 12th chapter, 15th chapter. Isaiah talks about him. Isaiah 33. Luke talks about him in Luke 6. 1 Peter talks about him. Hallelujah. In chapter 2. They don't mention his name, but they talk about him indirectly because they talk about honoring and doing things integrous and doing things that will put you in line to be blessed. My wife is going to come and pray.
Glory, glory. Father, we thank you and we praise you on this morning, O God. We give you glory, honor, and praise, O God. We thank you for the word of God this morning, Lord. We thank you, Heavenly Father, and this morning we pray a prayer of Jabez, Lord God. We pray and we ask, O God, that you enlarge our territory and bless us, God. But Lord, as you bless us, take away the pain and the sorrow and the trouble. For your word tells us that you maketh rich your blessings, maketh rich and addeth no sorrow. So we declare today, Lord God, that we will receive the blessings of the Lord. We declare today, Lord God, that our hearts are healed. We declare today, Lord God, that we are no longer walking bound. We declare, Lord God, that you're healing us, you're ministering to us, and you're blessing us. Now, Father, we thank you that every place our feet tread upon, Lord God, that we're beginning to gain it, Lord God. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that even as Jabez prayed, Lord God, many of us, oh God, was raised and reared by our mothers and our grandmothers. So God, those things that were taught to us, Lord, we thank you right now, Lord, that we will put them in remembrance. And then, Father, we thank you and we declare that we are an integral people. Lord, even as Jabez, Lord, that we are a debt-free people, Lord, that we have integrity, not just in our character, but Lord, in our finances. We thank you, Lord God, for financial integrity, my God. Lord, we thank you this morning for financial integrity, God, where we will not waste money. We will not just be loose with money, God. But in this season, God, teach your people how to be integral, Lord. We thank you that even as we're sowing into the kingdom of God, Lord God, rather it's our time with our finances, with our love, with our compassion, Lord, that it is an integral thing, God, that what we do is done with no motive. Name of Jesus, we glorify you this morning, hallelujah. We glorify you for integrity this morning, God, from the pits of our soul, God. We thank you, Lord God, that we are holy and that we are righteous people. We thank you, Lord God, that we are a praying people. Lord, we see in your word that Jabez was a man of prayer. So God, we declare today that we are intercessors. We are women and men of God who will pray, God, and pray your will. Pray until something changes. Lord, we will pray not only for ourselves, but for the families and friends and those who we know and love, God, and those who we don't know. Now, God, we declare that you're enlarging our territory and blessing us so that we can be a blessing to the homeless, so that we can be a blessing to those in the kingdom, so we can be a blessing to families that are in need, Lord God. We thank you right now, Heavenly Father, that we're praying for communities this morning. Lord, that those who live in communities will begin to serve their communities and live a righteous lifestyle. We declare today, Lord God, that we are the salt and the light to the community. We are the salt and the light to the world. We are carrying your spirit, oh God. And those who are looking, Lord, are looking for your spirit and your integrity. So we declare and decree today, Lord God, that the body of Christ will walk in integrity in this season. Not just integrity in our character, but financial integrity. Now, God, we also pray for financial literacy. For Lord, as you're wanting to bless us, as you gave us this word this morning, Lord, we ask it for financial literacy. Hallelujah. Financial discipline. In the name of Jesus, oh God, we pray over the finances of the people of God this morning. And we declare, we pray over their mindsets, Lord God, that you will begin to plead. We plead the blood of Jesus against poverty mindsets that says spend more than what you have. Spend more than what you earn. Oh, God. But, Lord, we declare that the chains of poverty are breaking off because the blessings of the Lord maketh rich and addeth no sorrow. So, God, we thank you. We declare and decree, Lord God, that integrity is the portion of the day. And that you're expanding our territory this morning, Father. And we glorify you and we magnify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God and amen. My way.
You've been listening to CWM Radio Show. That was your host, Apostle Michael Branch, and we thank God for you tuning in each and every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Amen. If you missed this broadcast, go back, listen to the replay, and enjoy the word from the Lord on tonight. The Jabez, amen, prayer, praying, amen, with faith and honor. Glory to God, amen, with a loving heart. We thank you again for being a listener of the Timmy Radio broadcast and all its associates, affiliates. Thank you so much. Again, you've been listening to your radio host, Apostle Michael Branch, on CWM Radio. Meet us back here on next Tuesday night at 7 p.m. And at 8 o'clock, coming up in just a minute, we'll be Circle of Love, Prayer Partners Radio. Prayer, praise, and worship with your radio host, Evangelist Linda Ellis, at 8 o'clock p.m. So tune in and be blessed.
Power, living on the inside, Jesus. when this life is over, that when we leave this place, we want to go to heaven. Come on.
I'm going to heaven, and I hope to see you there, where there's no more sickness, in Hallelujah Square.
I'll see my father and my mother too. If you die in the will of God, I'll see you too.
On up in glory, where we'll be together, where we'll lift our hands and rejoice with Jesus Christ forever. On up in glory, when our race is won.
I wanna hear my father say, I wanna hear him say, well done.
It's a place where there's only tears of joy, never tears of pain. And every day is sunny and bright, no more clouds or rain.
Where we can sing and shout and praise his holy name. Well, there'll be no more cares of this world ever again.
I heard the streets up there are paved with gold. Where there's so much love up there, you can rest your soul. That's where we'll meet our King and bow before his majesty.
And scream and praise his name for what he's done for me.
Hold up in glory, where we'll be together,
where we'll lift our hands and rejoice with Jesus Christ forever, yeah.